Look, over there.
They're on the back side of that building somewhere. Hey, keep eyes in case they start egressing to the west. There they are! There they are! Hey, 240 gunner needs to scoot up to the edge of the wall. You're on target, but scoot the fuck up.
Go!
I hit that first guy. He's fucking dead.
I like to hear, baby.
I hit that guy right in the fucking head.
Fuck
30
yeah.
30
second left.
Well, that was intense.
Man, those fucking assholes are using those kids and women as cover to get out of there. Horse shit, man.
Oh, God.
Give me a 203. Come here, Nemez. Here's what I want you to hit. See those sweet trees right there?
Those big ones?
You see those big tall ones?
Yeah.
Just right on the other side of that building. I want you to pepper them.
Hey, range is 300.
300.
Building 7, you'll whip it through that fucking right window, you understand? That's the one that's been shooting at us. All from the pork chop.
Holy fuck.
Holy shit. You guys suck ass.
So let's score the team.
Solid copy. We're in building 4, and pretty sure that 3 took contact from either building 10 or 11. It was right on top of us. Yeah, victory is achieved.
Bravo enter the pork chop and find the Taliban have fled.
Look out, look at our position from here. That roof right there is where we ambushed them.
That's the roof you guys were on?
Yep. I was behind that little triangle thing standing up.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. As you can see from here, it's a perfect position. It totally isolates the entire rest of the town. They had nowhere to go. We had them completely trapped.
Oh, you weren't that far then.
These bitches didn't have a chance.
No.
And they had no idea we were up there.
No, they didn't.
No.
Huge moral victory for the company.
Oh my gosh.
just didn't work, did they, motherfucker?
556?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Flashlight. Yeah.
He died right where he was laying. He had his hand, rigor mortis had set in around his, around the rifle, so he was still gripping it. I think it's a 8mm Mauser.
What are you gonna do with him?
What, him?
Yeah.
I don't believe we're gonna do anything with him. We're just leaving him.
Back here.
Put it in a different room. Sir, what is it?
Hey,
Mori,
there was a Taliban sauce of Corona. Can you look on the store?
No,
they say he was not Taliban either, but they forced him to give him a gun. The Taliban forced him to give them a gun to you.
This is it. We roughly knew where he was. Perfect sniper right position.
What?
Man, I think they're just...
Roger, COC. I believe we've identified the sniper position, break. There's a vertical loophole in the wall here, break. Has perfect side alignment for the post for Lamont, and the snipers were hit. Break. And we found 17.556 rounds.
The sniper was less than 300 meters from Bravo's base.
Look at our post.
Was one of your men shot from here?
Three of them, actually. Four. Three medevacs, for sure. So he's probably sitting back in the room in the shadow where we couldn't see indication of his weapon at all. Shooting through the slit in the wall. Perfect angle.
To know that he has to be far enough back so that his muzzle flash isn't seen. And certainly to engage targets. You know, he was hitting him in the chest and in the head from back here. So he was probably well-trained military. Absolutely.
Yep.
What military would have trained him?
Possibly ours at some point.
Probably using a weapon that we supplied him in some way or another. But good to know we found a spot and we own it now. We're burning daylight. This
yep.
is done.
All right, we're ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Let's continue the game.
Bravo's mission enters its next phase, winning over the local population.
The next part is to hold the area that we have. Once we push the enemy out, we have to hold security here and allow the people to start to move back in and resume their daily lives. And then from there, we have to, you know, we build on, you know, what we've established. We help them, you know, open their schools back up and open their bazaars back up and establish police stations and the local government and, you know, allow the local government to start, you know, building their projects as well. So that, you know, in the grand scheme, that's kind of how counterinsurgency works. Gentlemen, thank you all for coming. My name's Captain Ryan Sparks. We're very happy. It's a great day that we can, you know, the Taliban are gone and we can finally start to open your bazaar back up. Get all of your stores repaired. Fix anything that's broken so that you can start your life again as soon as possible.
Hey, first store open, baby!
The Taliban will eventually lose their freedom of movement. They'll become irrelevant and, you know, they'll just dissipate. They'll become irrelevant.
So far, Bravo, of course, no civilian casualties. But the fighting had been so intense that Charlie Company was sent in as backup. During a firefight, they fired a rocket into a house sheltering three families. 11 people were injured and 4 killed. One woman and 3 children. Marines from Bravo and Charlie organize a meeting with the men from one of the families.
Have you guys seen McLean?
What's up, bro?
You here for this meeting?
Yeah.
A condolence payment of $10,000 will be made. $2,500 per life.
You're looking at the definition of innocent people. There's no question about it, you know, little girls. I mean, there's just no way to rationalize that this was in any way a good thing or justified. It's just a terrible feeling, a terrible sight.
Seguimos tratando de llegar a este lugar.